Former U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo sat down with CBN founder Pat Robertson for an exclusive one-on-one interview. In this first segment, they discuss the danger of a nuclear Iran and the great success of the Abraham Accords.
It looks like the same thing with Iran. They are just threatening us in the Straits of Hormuz and these other places, and yet are we able to take them on? I mean, going back to that joint forces agreement with nuclear weapons, I mean, if they get the nuclear bomb, it'll be a disaster.
Yes, it'll be a disaster for us. It'll certainly be a total disaster for the Jewish people in Israel, and frankly, Christians and Arabs living in Israel, but the Jewish homeland of Israel, right? The Iranians have demonstrated their genocidal intent with respect to Israel.
Exactly.
And we can never let them get a nuclear weapon. I remember, you'll appreciate this. We had some Iranian Coast Guard cutters come around one of our ships when we were we were first in. President Trump said, okay, if they come close again, take whatever action you need. We communicated that to the Iranians, that this was our policy, and we never had that problem again.
We had it just a few days ago.
And we just had it. They're testing President Biden. They're going to see if he has the same resolve that President Trump had and that our team had. I hope and pray that they do, because while they're in Vienna negotiating to hand back a whole bunch of money to the Iranians, when the U.S. negotiators are willing to hand over everything, the Iranians are flying over our ships, approaching our cutters, enriching uranium at levels they have never enriched before. And our friends in Israel, frankly, our Arab state Gulf partners as well, who work with security issues, they all see this, and they will be put in an incredibly difficult position.
Well, you know, it's amazing. The Abraham Accords that you guys put together were just an incredible thing.
40 years of failed policy where right, the central premise was if you don't solve this problem between the Palestinians and Israel, then nothing can move forward. We said that's just crazy. And by the way, if we're wrong, so be it. We can't do any worse than y'all did. And so so we took a completely different approach and began to build out. It took us almost 4 years to build out the trust and confidence of those Arab leaders and frankly of Prime Minister Netanyahu as well. But once we did that, we got this glorious outcome, these Abraham Accords, which will change the nature of how ordinary citizens in the Middle East live for decades to come.
It was absolutely brilliant. Well, now, do you think Saudi's going to come along and will they sign a peace deal with Israel? I think they probably want to, don't they?
I think so.
Yeah.
I think so. I think the Saudi people want to as well. I think that's always the thing that's most important. But it's harder if the American president isn't strong enough to stand behind and provide support to that. There's no doubt that President Trump, as a leader, enabled those Abraham Accords to come together. It took great leaders in Bahrain, in Emirates, and in Israel, but you needed America. You needed America to be there working and have confidence that the American Secretary of State would assist them in making it all go. I'm not sure that we have that under President Biden today. That may make it more difficult for the Saudis, but I'm confident that this is a one-way ratchet, that this peace will continue to build.